quick sky replacement in DaVinci Resolve. Let's get right into it. So I've already got a timeline open and a B-roll waiting. For this effect, we're gonna head over straight to Fusion. So here in Fusion, as you can see, we have two nodes, our media one, which is our B-roll, and our media out, where everything we do in between here will be rendered back into the timeline. So sky replacement is a very simple thing to do. Just make sure you have a clear sky, click on your media one, hit shift spacebar on the keyboard, and look for the delta gear. Let's add it to the node graph. Let's make sure it's connected. Now, making sure your inspector is open, we're gonna come to the background color, select this color picker right here, and drag it to the clip. Now make sure to drag it over the whole gradient of the sky, like this, and there we go. Our sky disappeared and became an alpha background. So to see the result of the keying, we're gonna change the fill mode from final result to matte. And we're also gonna come to matte to fine tune our keying. Now here in threshold, we gotta make sure the whole sky is black, which it actually is, so we're looking good. If it's not, you can play around with these sliders, like this. Let's go back to key and final result. But as you can see, we have a problem here. Our keying also affected the lake and the pants. So how do we fix that? It's very simple. We can drag a polygon mask to our node graph, connect it to this blue input of the delta keyer, and mask out our B-roll, like this. And boom. Now only the sky is affected by the keying. Let's check our borders to see if they're okay. Let's click on the delta keyer, come to matte, mess around with the roll dilate. Okay, looking good. Can give it a little blur, like this. Now let's add our clouds. I'm gonna open the media pool and bring a cloudy image to the node graph, like this. I'm gonna connect it with the merge node, like this. So we're gonna make some adjustments first. We're gonna click on our clouds and add a resize node to make it the size of our comp, like this. And we're gonna add a transform node so we can manipulate it. And as you can see, the clouds have taken over the whole screen. And that's because our clouds are in the foreground or in this green arrow right here. And we have to put it in the background. We can do that by clicking on our merge node and hit Command or Control T on the keyboard. And now, as you can see, it's in the background or in this yellow arrow right here. We can increase the size a little bit, like this, place it the way we see fit, like this. So let's take a quick look. And as you can see, this camera has a very soft movement. We don't have to mind about that. It won't affect our image. But let me know in the comments if you want me to make a video about sky replacement with a moving camera. Okay, one panel adjustment. As you can see, we have a bit of a wind going on here. So let's give our clouds a little movement. Let's come to transform and making sure we're at the beginning of the clip. We're gonna set a keyframe right here on center. Now we're gonna come to the end of the clip and move it a little bit to the right, like this. So let's take a look at the final result. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you want to learn more about DaVinci Resolve, check out this video showing you on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.